Welcome to the Chapter 10 lecture about the rational consumer. This chapter will develop the tools to analyze how consumers make decisions. We will start by introducing a concept called utility, which is how economists measure consumer satisfaction from the consumption of goods and services. Utility analysis. The term utility means happiness, satisfaction, and/or pleasure from consuming goods and services. Total utility is the total satisfaction you derive from consumption. In comparison, marginal utility is the change in total utility from a one-unit change in consumption. It is important to keep in mind the law of diminishing marginal utility, which states that added satisfaction declines as you consume additional units of a good or service. I think a perfect example of diminishing marginal utility is Girl Scout cookies. The first cookie is so delicious since you haven't had one in a long time. The second cookie is very good, but not as tasty as the first. The third cookie is still good, then the fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh cookies are consumed, and now you have a stomach ache and you regret eating so many cookies. Some general notes about utility. Utility and usefulness are not synonymous. A painting might bring you happiness, but is not necessary for daily life. Utility is highly subjective. What brings me happiness might not bring you happiness. Maybe you love caramel delight cookies like me. Maybe you like Thin Mints. Maybe you are an ice cream person. Maybe you like big trucks, or maybe you like Mini Coopers. Everyone is different and will receive different levels of utility. Lastly, utility is difficult to quantify. Since we are measuring satisfaction from consumption, we are using imaginary units called utils. Let's look at utility graphically. Total utility from taco consumption will be shown on the top diagram, and marginal utility will be shown on the bottom diagram. Taco consumption will range from 0 to 7. Consuming one taco will result in 10 utils of satisfaction. Two tacos will result in 18 utils, three tacos, 24 utils, four tacos, 28 utils, five tacos, 30 utils, six tacos, 30 utils, seven tacos, 28 utils. Now we can calculate marginal utility, the change in total utility from a one-unit increase in consumption. Eating one taco results in a marginal utility of 10. Two tacos will cause marginal utility to increase by 8 utils. Three tacos, 6 utils. Four tacos, 4 utils. Four tacos, 4 utils. Five tacos, 2 utils. Six tacos, 0 marginal utility. Seven tacos, marginal utility will be negative 2 utils. The diagram showing marginal utility is a great visual of the law of diminishing marginal utility. Additional satisfaction decreases as more tacos are consumed. In fact, the seventh taco yields dissatisfaction since marginal utility is negative. Marginal utility and demand. The law of diminishing marginal utility helps explain the law of demand. Since successive units of a good yield smaller and smaller amounts of marginal utility, consumers will buy additional units of a product if the price decreases. For example, additional tacos that yield lower levels of utility are not worth buying unless price decreases. Utility maximization. Let's analyze how consumers can maximize their happiness. In a world with scarcity, if a good is free, you increase consumption as long as marginal utility is positive. Consumers will purchase goods as long as those goods yield happiness. In a world with scarcity, consumers purchase goods so the last dollar spent on each product yields the same amount of marginal utility. This is called the utility maximizing rule or consumer equilibrium. In algebraic form, marginal utility of good X divided by the price of good X equals the marginal utility of good Y divided by the price of Y. This formula may seem complicated at first, but we will review a numeric example. Let's look at the utility maximizing combination of products A and B that a consumer can purchase with an income of $10. Product A costs $1 and product B costs $2. First, we're going to look at margin utility to ensure these products are providing satisfaction to the consumer. Margin utility for the first unit of product A is 10, and margin utility for the first unit of product B is 24. Next, we're going to compare margin utility per dollar. MU divided by P for product A is 10. MU divided by P for product B is 12. The consumer will first purchase product B. Now we will look at the next item. Margin utility of the second unit of product B is 20. Therefore, MU divided by P is 10. The consumer will buy a second unit of product B and the first unit of product A. The consumer has spent $5 and has $5 remaining. The third unit of product B yields a margin utility of 18. Therefore, margin utility per dollar is 9. The second unit of product A yields a margin utility of 8. Therefore, margin utility per dollar is 8. The consumer will purchase the third unit of product B. The fourth unit of product B yields a marginal utility of 16. Therefore, margin utility per dollar is 8. The consumer will purchase the fourth unit of product B and the second unit of product A. The consumer has spent all of their income. The final result is 2 units of product A and 4 units of product B. We can analyze this process by using an algebraic formula for utility maximization. Margin utility of product A divided by the price of good A equals the margin utility of product B divided by the price of product B. At 2 units of product A, margin utility is 8 utils and the price is $1. At 4 units of product B, margin utility is 16 utils and the price is $2. Simplifying this formula will result in 8 utils per dollar equaling 8 utils per dollar. The consumer is at equilibrium. Income is allocated so the last dollar spent on each product yields the same marginal utility. This is the end of the Chapter 10 lecture. If you have any questions about this material, please post and ask Professor Pakula or send me an email.